The question says, parabola's y square is equal to 4a x minus c1 and x square is equal to 4a y minus c2, where c1 and c2 are variables, right? Now friends, here c1, c2 are like parameters. Parameters means they are constants only, but they keep on changing. So as this c1 changes, the parabola will change, right? So as the c2 change, this parabola will also change, right? So as we all know, the position of the vertex of the parabola will keep on changing. Now these two parabola are variable parabolas because they are linked to the parameters c1 and c2. Now the question is asking that if these two parabolas touch each other, what is the locus of their point of contact? What is the locus of their point of contact? Now friends, let me tell you, JEE Main, the question based on locus are very, very important. JEE simply loves locus questions. Okay. So how will I solve this question? First thing in my mind that comes is, first I will find the derivative of both these parabolas. So I'll find dy by dx for parabola p1. Okay. And I'll equate the dy by dx for both the parabolas. Because if the two parabolas touch each other at a common point, that means the slope of the tangent at that point of touching should be the same. Yes or no? Okay. So let's see, what do we get, and we'll assume the point of touching to be h comma k. That's the point where the two parabolas touch each other, and then we'll generalize this. Then we'll generalize this point. So with this roadmap in our mind, let us proceed towards solving the problem. So let's take the first parabola, y square is equal to 4a x minus c1. Okay. So let's differentiate both sides with respect to x. So 2y dy by dx will become 4a, which implies dy by dx is going to be 2a by y. Please remember, we are finding this at a point h comma k. So we have to substitute the point in our dy by dx expression, which simply becomes 2a by k. Okay. Now let's do the same for the second curve as well, which is x square is equal to 4a y minus c2. So the derivative of this with respect to x will be 2x, and we have 4a dy by dx coming from the right hand side. So dy by dx becomes x by 2a. And again, since we are finding it as at h comma k, let me replace my x with h. Okay. As we already discussed in the roadmap 2, that dy by dx for both the parabolas should be the same, right? For both the parabolas should be the same. So we'll equate these two. Let me call this as 1. Let me call this as 2. Okay. So equating 1 and 2, we obtain h by 2a is equal to 2a by k, which implies hk is equal to 4a square. Now having done that, we will do the next step, which is the process of generalization. Generalization means you replace your h with x and k with y. That's the typical standard procedure that we follow in case of locus questions. So my answer would be xy is equal to 4a square, which is option number C. So option number C is correct. So friends, in this problem, we learned that if two curves are touching each other at a given point, then at that point, the slope of the tangent drawn to both the curves should be the same. And secondly, we learned how to actually deal with a locus problem. So keep practicing locus problems.